So can you tell us more? What do you mean by the art of dying?
Yeah, the main thrust of this genre was that in order to die well, we have to live well. And in order to live well, we have to attend to these big questions of what does that actually mean? And the Ars Moriendi was very much a set of practices. So it included all different kinds of things. And I should just note that originally it sort of grew out of the Catholic Church. Now this is pre-Reformation, so we're talking about the early 1400s. We date one of our earliest copies of an Ars Moriendi text to 1415. And then there were many, many spin-offs. And, you know, after the Reformation, there was a explicitly Protestant version. And by the 1800s, the Ars Moriendi had come to the U.S. There were secular versions. There were Jewish versions. So really, you know, by the time of the Civil War in the 1860s in the United States, if you were from a good family, if you were brought up well, you attended to the preparation for death by thinking over the course of your life within the context of your community about what it means to die well. So you know, and say maybe our equivalent is estate planning, right? So if you're brought up well, you sort of get your financial affairs in order. But going way back, it wasn't just getting those sort of pragmatic affairs in order, but it was also attending to, you know, spiritual questions, community questions, questions of the soul, right? These sorts of things. And so this was a part of it. So it was a genre of literature. There were illustrated versions, text-based versions. They would include everything from protocols for attending to the dying and caring for the dead, all the way through to Q&A, like a catechism. That the community would ask of the dying person. It would include prayers, both for the dying person to pray on his or her own behalf, and also for the community to sort of intercede on behalf of the dying. One of the big thrusts of the original versions was attention to the five main temptations that, at least in the late Middle Ages, they thought the dying would face. And that would be things like a temptation to impatience, right? Let me just die and get this over with. Or a temptation to greed. I want to take my earthly possessions with me. And so they articulated these different temptations and then articulated sort of a response or a consolation to those temptations. So this was the core of some of the original versions. And like I said, there were so many spin-offs.